You are listening to I Am Refocused Radio with your host, Shamaya Reed. This show is designed to inspire you to live your purpose and regain your focus. And now, here's your host, Shamaya Reed.
Hey, welcome to I Am Refocused Radio. We are here once again on a Sunday morning on 9:30 a.m. The Answer, and I'm your host, Shamaya Reed. We have another special guest on this Sunday morning. And also, if you are listening to radio and you know someone who may be still asleep today, maybe just share the link. We are on iamrefocusedradio.com. We're going to have bonus shows pretty soon. And also, every show that's aired on this station, 9:30 a.m. The Answer, will also be available on iamrefocusedradio.com. Share that with everybody, because San Antonio and wherever you are listening to the world, you, the listener, I want you to be inspired, and I want you to find your focus and find your purpose in life, because that's what the show is all about. We have an awesome guest today, Mr. Manny Diotte. He's the founder of the Ferrari Kid organization. And before we get too deep into this show, I just want to say thank you, sir, clearing your calendar to give us this opportunity to talk to you this morning.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I love to support this, so thank you.
Before we go deeply into your organization, tell the listener, man, a little bit about yourself.
Oh, wow. So I was born in Spain, really. I came to America when I was 4 years old. Unfortunately, developed cancer at a really young age, 7, given 6 months to live. And through the grace of God, I beat some amazing odds. So got the privilege of traveling and speaking and sharing my story all over the world and building a business and now growing my roots here in San Antonio, where I spend almost my entire life building a nonprofit here. So really my background, just a young kid born in a ghetto in Spain, came to America and trying to live the American dream, you know, grinding it out every day.
And take us back to that moment when you found out that you were diagnosed with cancer. What was going through your mind? Like, how were you facing that? Because that's a tough thing, man.
Yeah, you know, I was 7 and I wasn't really sure what was going on. My parents were really sheltering me from, I just knew I was going to the doctor a lot, getting a lot of blood drawn, a lot of tests, and they didn't want to tell me I had 6 months to live. They just kind of, you know, because back then, in something, you know, there was chemo, radiation, all kinds of options back then that could have changed the direction of it. So they were kind of sheltering me. But I knew something was up because I was just going to the hospital way too many times as a kid. And finally, I started to ask enough questions and they just said, you know, you're really sick. And then one of the nurses, you know, I just developed a great relationship, finally said, Manny, you may not see Christmas. That's how sick you are. So we need to make sure we get all the tests and things that you need to make sure you have the best chance on living.
And when you started to go through the process, how did you keep yourself inspired? How did you keep your spirit up?
Yeah, I think even now, how do I keep my spirits up is the same thing that I did back then, is I surrounded myself really with the right people. I wanted to hang out with people who spoke life into my life, people who were not going to, you know, be the Debbie Downers of the world. Everything is horrible. And I wanted people around me, my doctors, my friends, that say, hey, you're going to get through this. It's going to be all right. Even if they didn't know, I wanted them to speak that over me than anybody else. And even now, you know, my mom used to say, you are who you hang around with. You're a product of the 5 people you hang out with the most. So I wanted to hang out with people. I never wanted to be the smartest person in the room. I wanted to have people who inspire me and help me grow. Does that make sense?
There's something special that happened in Beverly Hills, California, 1987.
Yep.
You know where I'm going with this. Tell the audience, man, what happened?
Yeah, so they were going to amputate my leg. I was, you know, I've had 50 surgeries, and back then I had about 17, 18 at the time. And they wanted to amputate my leg. They thought this infection was going to kill me. So Michael Jackson's doctor took an interest in my story, saying, like, how come this kid at 7 still alive at 18? Like, you know, but he's in for surgery and surgery and surgery. So he said, listen, before you amputate his leg, let me take a look at it. So they flew me to Beverly Hills. I get to the airport, and you know, I was born in the in a ghetto in Spain. So I don't know what Ferraris and Lamborghinis and all these cars are. I just walked out of the airport. I see the most beautiful red car I've ever seen in my life. So I run up to the guy who I assume is the owner standing next to it and said, "Sir, can I take a picture of your car?" And he let me take a picture. Then he said, "Man, I wish I had time to give you a ride. You're so happy." Yeah. And I still have that picture actually on my website today, which inspired, you know, down the line, my life's work.
And that's amazing. And once again, if you're just tuning in to this show, this is I Am Refocused Radio. I'm your host, Shamai Reed. On 9:30 a.m., The Answer, we are interviewing right now in the studio, Manny Diotte. He is the owner, founder of the Ferrari Kid. .org is the website. So once again, back to the story, when you had that moment capturing history, that image, how did that make you feel that you was in that car, man?
Yeah, it was just amazing. It was amazing to me, and it was so amazing that it's like 30 years later I did something. You know, Maya Angelou inspired me with this quote that says, you know, people will forget what you say and what you do, but they'll never forget how you made them feel. So when I put kids now in Ferraris, I know how it makes them feel, and I create these memories that last forever, because even me, who just taking a picture next to something that I thought was just grandiose at the time for me, made me feel amazing, and I just never forgot that feeling. So, you know, here I am, you know, 30 plus years later, still on cloud nine about that experience, and now we take kind of a similar experience, only 10x it to the next level for the kids we serve.
I like how you said 10x, because there's a little entrepreneur side to that little statement that you see a lot in social media. But back to you, when you decided that this organization, the FerrariKid.org, how soon after that picture did that spark come to you when you say, you know what, I can actually do this?
Yeah, it took a long time. So I was about 18 when that happened, and I didn't start the Ferrari Kid till I was 42. Mm-hmm. But what had happened, it had always tugged in my heart. But what happens, Shema, in the beginning of my career, we're all focused on success. Everybody tells you the worldly view of success, go make money, do this, do that. So I was so young, I wasn't really focused on what I am now. So there's a difference between success and significance. Yeah. So in the beginning, I felt I was chasing success. Mm-hmm. And then when I found out what that formula was just serve more people. You know, if I'm a real estate agent, I sell a house, I deserve a commission. If I sell 10, I deserve 10. So if I want to make more money in any industry, just serve more people. So now we got that out of the way. But what really matters is significance, is what are you going to do with your gifts, your blessings, the things you want to do for the world. So I was really at a point where, you know, golly, the success is not fulfilling me. You know, having the toys and this and that is, I mean, yeah, there's no, you know, I'm not knocking hard work and getting those things that you work hard for, but I wanted to be significant. So I was talking about the Ferrari Kid. I said, what if I put kids in Ferraris and gave them shopping sprees and gave them bodyguard service and meet and greet with local celebrities like the San Antonio Spurs and all that? And I got tired of talking. So it's tired of it. Now you got to step out on faith and say, okay, what am I going to do about it? And I did. And now the Ferrari Kid for the last 7 years has just skyrocketed. It's just grown and grown and grown. So it's really a beautiful thing to see, because I decided to follow the desire of my heart and, you know, at the right time, but really yield to my calling, which I probably should have yielded a long time ago.
But what's powerful with what you're talking about is, number one, Manny been through cancer. Mm. You had to fight this yourself.
Right.
So when parents are with their kids who are battling cancer and they come to your organization and they find out that you yourself were a fighter, share with us some of the stories, maybe one that pops in your head where a parent talks to you and maybe finds out the first time that you actually had to fight cancer yourself.
Yeah, so it happens all the time. They understand that I run a charity for kids coping with cancer and other illnesses. It could be autism, special needs. We take everybody, no matter what the illness is now. And I'm encouraging the kid's heart, because once a month, after that big grand experience, I have a Hope Tank event every month, which is like an encouragement club. So I will go bowling or we'll go do something fun. And then I'm sitting down with the kids, asking them about their treatment. And I'll make a statement like, I remember when I was going through my chemo and I lost my hair. You got to stay really grounded with your friends. And then parents' eyeballs light up like, you had cancer? You know, like, yes. So now I come from a place that is not just doing something for the kid, but I come from a place of understanding because I've been through that journey as when I, because I had it when I was a kid. So they totally get it. It's like the connection instantly goes deeper.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, you're talking at a superficial level to a little bit deep level. But when we have that in common, bam, people go deep real quick. And then it just is like they light up. They're so grateful that someone went like me who went through something like that was is able to inspire their kid who's currently going through something like
that. I mean,
like
that's motivation right there.
Yeah.
You know, that's motivation to understand that someone's actually walked in those shoes.
Right.
You know, it's not just like you're saying that you want to do something special for the community. You actually been down that road. Yeah. And you survived it. And when you have these opportunities to work with these kids and just set their mind off of those procedures that they had to go through with the doctor visits, what's some of the things that the kids are able to experience for the day when you're doing these programs with them?
Yeah, so the first thing is they just could be kids. So, you know, they could be silly and laugh and not worry about what's going on, IV poles, chemotherapy scheduled, you know, surgery scheduled. So once I remind them, hey, I spent 3.5 years in the hospital and I've had 50 surgeries and we have that instant connection and we can get past that. But like today, it's just let's just be kids. So we start our events always. We put them in a Ferrari. We take them to some cool location like the shopping mall. I have a red carpet and paparazzi when they arrive and they're signing autographs. They ain't thinking about their treatment. They ain't thinking about anything but being a kid. They laugh and they're silly and they get embarrassed and they're just being a kid, which is what I want them to be. We provide bodyguard service. So here's a group of girls walking down the mall and these big bodyguards and everybody's like, who are these kids? Who are these kids? These must be celebrity kids. And they are celebrity kids, you know? So it's just things like that. Or when I do a meet and greet with one of the San Antonio Spurs, like Tony Parker or Danny Green and some of the players that have come and gone, and they just, wow, their eyes just light up like a kid would light up, you know, and they ain't thinking of their treatment or their medicine they got to take. They're just being a kid, and it's very rewarding, but it's also very rewarding to watch the parents see their kid being a kid. And one of the cool things that we do, too, is we invite the family members, the brothers and siblings, to be part of that day because, you know, they go through that journey with that sibling, too. So we don't want to exclude them. We want to include them in that day.
Once again, if you're just now tuning in, you're listening to I Am Refocused Radio here on 9:30 a.m. The Answer. We are interviewing Mr. Manny Diotte, the founder of the FerrariKid.org. And real quick, Manny, someone right now, this listener is listening to this episode and saying, you know, how can I get involved? Or maybe they know someone that will benefit from this service. What's the process of someone to nominate a kid on the FerrariKid.org?
Yeah, so the process is real simple. How do they get involved is time, treasure, talent, or connections. I'll talk about those four in a second. But if they know of a kid that's sick or suffering, if they themselves have a kid that's sick and suffering, we have locations in Dallas, in Austin, San Antonio, Houston. We're going to do an event in South Texas. So they just go to the website, theferrarikid.org, kind of like thekaratekid.org, theferrarikid.org. And there's a big button that says nominate a kid. And they just nominate it. And there's no process like 100% of the kids nominated are accepted. We don't say yes, no, this one, yes, no, to that one. 100%. They just get on the waiting list, and we get to them as soon as possible. And then the ways they can help is time, treasure, talent, connections, right? If someone doesn't have money, they can volunteer time. We always need volunteers. I mean, the more paparazzi, the more people to love on the kids when they arrive, the better. Time, treasure. If someone is blessed and enough and they want to sponsor a kid or a group of kids, they definitely can give a gift. And we have all kinds of programs where they can say, hey, I want to sponsor for $500. I want to sponsor a kid for the entire year. Or you know what? I want to sponsor a group of kids. It's whatever's in their heart. So you got time, talent, treasure. If they play a musical instrument, they DJ, they you know, whatever. We have events where the kids learn how to, I have a friend that's a DJ that she's teaching them how to be a DJ for a day. And,
nice.
And you know, friends like you here in the studio, maybe we have a little meet and greet with you and you can see them behind the scenes, just little things that make them feel special.
Definitely.
And then lastly, connection. Like we had my girlfriend has a friend that knows Billy Ray Cyrus and they just sent him the video of Old Town Road that we did, the Ferrari Kid Edition, and instantly recently, he gave us social media love and we've got 25,000 hits overnight. Wow. And so someone may know someone who knows Ellen or someone at the Good Morning America show that's willing to say, hey, just check out this video. You just never know those connections, how valuable it can be to a nonprofit like me.
And speaking of that video, someone listening right now, they want to find that video. What's the title of it, or can they go right to the website and find it there?
Yeah, they go straight to YouTube. We're hosting it on YouTube. Just go Old Town Road Ferrari Kids. Nice. Or Old Town Road Kids with Cancer. Either one of those will pop right up to the top, and they're able to share that on their social media. We'd appreciate it. And get as many hits into those. Because those kids look at those numbers, and they feel, oh, my goodness,
oh, it's
25,000.
I mean, you know? That's more views than I got. But in all seriousness, in the last 10 minutes, you said something early in the show about success, and that's what the show is all about. I'm Refocus Radio is a constantly to refocus, because there's a lot of times where we think we're focused, right?
Right.
And before we know it, life happens. We don't get to choose when it happens. It just happens.
Right.
And that can throw us off our focus. That can throw us off our path. For you, from being successful to being a successful nonprofit, giving back to the community, how have you been able to define success for yourself?
Yeah, so success to me is just a different definition, you know, in terms of worldly stuff like toys, let's just say. I just believe whatever it is you want, create a work ethic that allows you to live the life you want to live. So if you want a Ferrari, create a work ethic that allows you to buy one. If you want to take 10 vacations a year, create a work ethic that allows you to do that. So, you know, so, but then beyond that, the real meaning for me is significance. What do I want to do that matters? So, you know, I'm always refocusing. I'm always going in. I may be going in one direction and I get pushed in this direction or that direction. I'm always kind of reinventing myself. I don't stay stagnant. You know, we're always doing new different things. I think that's very important to keep the energy up and not just, you know, stay at one place at the same time. And then spending time with myself and, you know, and just knocking out all the noise, because a lot of people have great interest. Oh, like, Manny, you should write another book, or Manny, you should do this, you should do that. And that creates a lot of stress when people telling you what you should be doing. So sometimes you just got to say, what is it that I want to do with my life?
Yeah.
Let me focus on that, and then I'll go in that direction. And if I have to change my mind 100 times, I'll change it. But as long as I'm moving in the right direction.
And once again, this is I'm Refocus Radio on 9:30 a.m. The Answer. I'm your host, Shamari Reed. Man, we're having fun. All I could say on last week's show, this show is too short in my opinion, but it's amazing because I have you all coming back, you the listener. Hopefully you find value in what we've been saying and what Manny has been preaching today, and that is finding your purpose. If you can't do nothing else in life, find your purpose, because in your purpose, you find your passion. In your passion, you find a way to give to the community that is of value, and most people are going to appreciate it.
Yeah, you know, you got to do the things that bring you the most joy. I talk about this and with my audiences and with my staff is to have your fun meter on max. You got to do things that bring you the most joy, and if you're not doing things that bring you joy, stop.
Yeah.
You know, we're not a tree. We're not stuck. We can just move to what something, and it's not about money. There's money in every industry. People have mastered. It's about doing the things that the desires of your heart, keeping your fun meter on max. Yes, there's things I have to do to make things happen that I may not like to do, but, you know, successful people are willing to do what unsuccessful people aren't willing to do. So I take the day to get those things done, but majority of my day, 80% of my day, I'm doing the things that have my fun meter on max, you know, and bring me joy. And that's super important.
I'm a visual person. When you just said that, I just thought about two things, music and a car. So music, you obviously have a musician who's playing an instrument, but they're not as good if they're not practicing.
That's right.
And for a car, it doesn't perform if it doesn't have maintenance.
That's right.
And I like what you're saying about having the fun meter maxed out, but understanding the roots, the core of what can allow you to have that fun.
Yep. And, you know, I learned a long time ago, I'll give you an example, Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee was mentoring someone, and he says, don't worry about the guy or gal that can do 10,000 moves and this and that. Worry about the one that can do one move 10,000 times, because that's mastery. So that's what happens when we get to doing what we love. Then we, how do we master that? How do I now take that gift, that musical gift, whatever that gift is, and maximize it, you know? And that's by repetition and practice and practice. And, you know, because I know, like, as a speaker, if I miss, I practice speaking before I speak on the stage. If I miss a day, no one knows it. If I miss a week, I know it. If I miss a couple, my audience knows it. So I've got to always be doing those things behind the scenes that make it look seamless when I'm on the platform.
Once again, I Am Refocused Radio. Man, we are having too much fun here in the studio with Manny. For that listener, though, whether it's a parent that has a child who is battling cancer, or know someone who's battling cancer right now, today, what words of encouragement would you like to give to that listener right now?
Yeah, well, other than the obvious of not to give up, we live in a time today where everything's fluid, everything's changing. You know, I was given 6 months to live in 1976 when chemo and radiation surgery was just the only option. And now today, wow, you fast forward, we have so many more options. We have so many more specialists. We have so many more intelligent male and female doctors, more than any time in history. So if I was a parent today dealing with a child that was sick or suffering, now with the internet, that, you know, you could Google this, everything's at your disposal. Don't give up. You continue to research. Find the best doctors. Find the best staff. You know, there's all kinds of different doctors, and there's all kinds of different cancers. So some hospitals treat this cancer better than the other one. So find that hospital. You know, if your child has Hodgkin's, find the best hospital for Hodgkin's. If your child has leukemia, find the best hospital for leukemia. And today, if the parent takes a proactive approach instead of a victim approach, saying, oh, it happened to me, and they sit there and cry, and there's a season, there's a time to do that. But then there's a time to say, let me empower my child by being proactive. Let me speak life into their life so they don't get depressed and they don't feel some of these other things. So if I was to encourage them, it's like, don't give up. Ask lots of questions till you get comfortable with the right answer. And if you're not comfortable with that answer is not speaking truth to you, then go see someone else. Go get a second opinion. Whatever it takes, you just keep that ball going.
There's a quote on your website. It says, you were born for greatness. Mm. And that's very fitting for this episode, because what you talked about the whole time is like we're driving with everybody in the cars or on your apps. If you're listening to this, once again, on 9:30 a.m., the answer, a little plug there. And you're driving and you're listening to the show and you're like, man, like this is, it's almost like medicine. And that's what the show is really like. That's the mission. Mm. Not to necessarily be actual medicine, but right, to be a source of inspiration to help people really find the best things of life.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times we see the negatives and we start to focus on those negatives and we don't develop what we already have on our plate. It's almost like you have a buffet line and you have all these choices that you can have, but we settle for that one item.
Right.
Sometimes people might feel, this is what life gave me, this is what I get out of life. But right, this quote on your, back to this, what I was trying to get driven to, is you were born for greatness. That's a powerful statement. And for you, Manny, to fight where you fought, and in a way you're still fighting. Mm. You're fighting for these kids.
Yes.
Because like you said earlier in the show, you are trying to get their mind off the current circumstance and just give them that one day to be a regular, happy kid. I'm going to let you have the floor and for this next minute, and once again, talk to those parents and talk to those kids and talk to those business owners who can help.
Yeah, so thank you. So the quote, you were born for greatness, is because, or I believe everybody was born with a specific purpose, and they were born for greatness. And once we figure out our gift, and sometimes it takes us, some of us longer, some of us shorter, to find out what our gifts were, our natural talents, where we can serve people, the sky's the limit. And then I believe the second thing in life is you get what you have the courage to ask for. So now that you have this, you got to go out and ask for what you need. And there's people there that are going to help you, people who blazed the path before me, like in fundraising. You know, I get the courage of, you know, I get what I have the courage to ask for. When I say, hey, would you sponsor a kid? Would you buy a table at my gala coming up November 9th? Will you? I've got to have the courage to ask for those things in order to receive those things. So, and since I do believe we were all born for greatness, that this is what I'm called to do, then I feel I have a responsibility to have the courage to ask what I need, and not let fear guide me, but let faith guide me and ask the courage for what I need. Even if the answer is no, that's okay. Someone else is going to say yes, because they are going to be called to help me. So I think at the end of the day, you know, it's talking to lots of people in my case so I can sponsor as many kids as possible. And whether, you know, again, they buy a table, they sponsor a kid, they come out and volunteer their time, it all adds up to us.
And once again, you're listening to Iron Refocus Radio on 9:30 a.m. The Answer with your host, Shamaya Reed. Special thank you to Manny Diotte, man. And once again, the FerrariKid.org. And if you can't spell, I got you. TheFerrariKid.org. I want you all to spread this show, and especially this episode with Manny Diotte, and share it with everybody. You, the listener, if you were really inspired by this, I really want you to go to ironrefocusradio.com. We have more shows with bonus stories that we might be recording in other places, because this right here is a platform to give the guest a voice and you, the listener, an opportunity to find your purpose. Mm-hmm. So if you have not gained focus, regain it today. See you next week.
Thank you.
San Antonio, need a barber? Visit our good friend Rico Rodriguez, the owner of Rockefeller's Barbershop in San Antonio, Texas, 1733 Babcock Road, and book your appointment today by calling 210-782-5188.